Hello, my name is Renske, and I'm going to be the first to travel all electric from the Netherlands to South Africa and back, charging the car with solar panels we take with us. It took me a while to dare to say this, as I have not done it yet, and it all started as a crazy idea at a birthday party. It still feels unnatural to do so, as I still have a bumpy road on the way ahead of me. You might wonder, why do you share this story then? More on that later, but first I want to give you more an idea of who I am and what's my motivation to do this. This is me and my partner. We found each other in our love for nature and adventure. On our third date, we went out wild camping in the Netherlands. And together and apart, we've seen many continents and countries. The more remote we go, the happier we are, all alone with nature. On the other hand, our passion for sustainability grew. At the moment, we live in a fully electric home. We pick up the garbage next to the street. We drive electric and we cook less meat to save the planet. Also in my work, I do what I can to implement sustainability. Here, I help entrepreneurs to implement sustainability in their business. For me, it just feels very good to be making those changes. It was 2.5 years ago that me and my partner traveled all the way to Namibia. This is a country in Africa. Here, we hired a car and started driving through the Sahara. We saw only sand for miles and miles, a few animals, but no humans at all. It was just beautiful. But it was also so hot that we stayed in the car as much as we could. It was here that we realized how much the impact could be of 0.5 degree more at the moment. Therefore, we decided to not fly anymore. But adventurous as we are, we did miss something. Therefore, we started thinking, was there no way to combine the two, traveling and sustainability? An electric car works fine for us. You just need a way to charge it when you are at the most remote places we want to go to, such as Africa, where there are no charging stations. We started thinking, why not just charge the car with solar panels you take with you? It hasn't been done before, but maybe it could work. At this point, we started sharing our story with friends and family. This was at the birthday party 8 months ago. We noticed that people were interested, but we also noticed the look of people not being able to imagine this could actually work. Therefore, we decided to turn it all around. We would share our story with the world and share our experience with them. As I think we can all agree that sustainability is very important. But to implement this, we need to make changes. And changes means uncertainty and therefore discomfort. By taking you with us on our journey, we want to share you how simple and practical it can be, and especially how much fun you can have along the way to be implementing those changes. And by sharing our story, we want to inspire you to take ownership as well and find ways to implement it in your life. This is it, our idea. And at this point, we started giving our project a name, 4x4 Electric, as we go on an adventure all electric. We will travel from the Netherlands to South Africa and back, which is about 40,000 kilometers. And all this way, we will travel with an electric car, charging with solar panels and sleeping on its roof. As we want to share more than just pretty pictures with you, we will visit all kinds of people and projects along the way that have implemented sustainability as well. What can we learn from them and how have they done this? We are very curious for our findings and look forward to sharing those with you. At this moment, our project has grown into an NGO. We have stakeholders, an administration, and a media plan. As we cannot do this alone, we work together with all kinds of partners. Network organizations, media partners, universities, and product producers. There's still a bumpy road ahead of us. And that's exactly the reason why I want to share my story now and not after the trip. Because what if I don't make it? what if I don't make the finish line? Then I would have failed. And believe me, I'm no different than you in not liking failure. And that's exactly the biggest lesson I've learned up until now. As the reason to fail often prevents us from even giving something a try. And this is such a shame. For me, I've had thousands of moments I was convinced I should stop. Also, just before this TED Talk. Because if I don't make it, then all of you would know I have failed. And even more important, I would have failed myself. But if I don't believe in me, how can I expect others to join me in doing so? And even more important, how can I give myself a fair chance in realizing this idea? I have a question for you. Do you have a dream yourself? Maybe an idea? And what is it that prevents you from realizing this idea at this moment? Is time the issue, or is tomorrow a better way to start? It's crazy, but that's how our brain works. We look for excuses all the time. And I've noticed I do that too, and I was looking for ways to prevent me from doing that. Along the process, I found some ways to do this, and those ways I want to share with you. It's four tips in total. Do with them what you want, but for me, they truly work. The first one is start sharing this idea that you have, because by doing so, you hear yourself speak, and you notice how your idea can improve. On the other hand, you get reactions from the people you're talking to. By absorbing all this feedback, you can improve your idea even more. To tell you the truth, our idea has changed so much from the beginning, 8 months ago. And this is not failing, this is growing. You just need to be able to adapt all the time. Sometimes you will feel hopeless. For me, this was just last week, as we were reaching out to a lot of potential partners. But for them, there's also a risk to fail, because if we fail, they fail as well. These moments, I want to give you my second tip. Do not give up. As you cannot move a mountain in one day, nobody can. But we can move stones. So when you have a big problem like that, cut it into smaller pieces, just small enough so that you feel that you can handle them. And then start moving those stones one by one. Agree with it that it's going step by step. But believe me, it truly works. Just start. And this brings me to my third tip. Have you moved one little stone? Celebrate it as a big success. As you need these happy feelings to keep you going when you have no success for a while. In the beginning of our project, we got only no as an answer, all the time, one and after. When we received our first yes, it was very huge for us. At the moment, it felt very small. As for me, this is a process and I learn as well. But this tip I want to give to you, the first success, celebrate it, as it's huge. And this brings me to my last tip, the fourth one. Start today, because we as humans are the best in finding reasons to start tomorrow. But someone once told me, yesterday is history, tomorrow is a mystery, and today is a gift. That is why it's called a present. Let's accept this present together and enjoy it. As for me, there's no option in failing anymore. I've already received so much from experiences like giving this TED Talk to you. I've also learned new skills, and I've had a lot of fun along the way. Therefore, I want to give you my lesson. Try not to give in to the fear of failing, as it makes you feel alive and it's a lot of fun. For me at this moment, I'm quite far ahead in the project, as since today we have the car, the electric car, and the rooftop tent, and we have no way of turning back anymore. We are going. If you like, you can join us by following us on 4x4 Electric. We are very much looking forward to this. Thank you very much for this chance. Okay.